Let's start.
We'll start with the original.
The Tobe Hooper classic.
Tobe Hooper classic, a horror cult film based on the actual crime. An actual crime.
Hey, back it.
A million quotation marks around actual crime.
We're not getting super deep into it, but it is based off Ed Gein.
Based in very Ed big Gein quotations.
Also, it's one of those like Ed Gein also had a lamp made out of skin. I'm like, that's not.
Have you ever seen Deranged?
No, I never saw that one.
Oh my god, it has the actor from Home Alone who plays the South Bend Shovel Slayer, and he's Ed Gein.
Okay.
It's fucking great. Bob Clark didn't do that. The other guy did, and I forget his name.
I don't know, but the point is, like, this is, like, I've looked into Ed Gein, and it's like, okay, there's a couple minor details, but I wouldn't say this is based off Ed Gein.
Well, no, but the idea of, like, cutting people's faces off and body parts out of into jewelry and lampshades and chairs and shit like that.
Yeah, there's that.
Yeah.
Inspired by crimes, I guess, but based on an actual crime.
But in 1974, there was nothing like this.
I feel like the commentary track for Texas Chainsaw, the first DVD I have there, I think they joked. They're like, yeah, everyone thought it was a true story. Yeah. But like, if we said it took place in 1973, you think they would have remembered it.
Yeah. If you go on Google right now, it says Texas Chainsaw Massacre, real story. And there's still people in 2022.
I think a lot of that also comes from the remake. We'll get to that.
Probably,
there.
Yeah.
All right. A horror cult film based on an actual crime from the director of Poltergeist, starring Marilyn Burns, Paul A. Partain.
Yeah. I think it's Partain.
Yeah. Edwin Neal, Jim Sydal, and Gunnar Hansen as Leatherface. Have you ever met Gunnar Hansen?
Yep. I've met Gunnar Hansen, Ed Neal, and Marilyn Burns.
Yeah, I met Gunnar Hansen. He was the first guy at a convention I like talked to, and he was the nicest guy.
Oh, he's so sweet. He's just this big guy.
Really nice guy.
He's legendary on our show.
Yeah, Movie Dumpster. He is one of the four wizards. Yeah,
the wizards of the MDU.
Of the Movie Dumpster universe.
He's the patron saint of the chainsaw.
Okay, here we go. Whoever you are, whatever you know, nothing in your experience could ever prepare you for the horror of the Texas Chainsaw Massacre. On what seemed like a perfect day in August 1973, five teenagers went for a drive. They were headed for a nightmare in a ghoulish house littered with the remains of dead animals. Waited a family of maniacal killers. They would emerge adorned with bones and skulls and animal skins to turn the peaceful Texas countryside into a human slaughterhouse.
They love that sound effect.
Producer and director Tobe Hooper, Poltergeist, delivers a riveting study of homicidal madness and psychological terror. Tape from 1986.
Yes, that is not... I know somebody's going to be like, why don't you have the Wizard VHS one? Because I don't have it. And I don't have the media either. I have, what is that, the Video Treasures one?
Yeah, Video Treasures. Can you grab mine, the one closest to you, Sean?
Okay.
Yeah, this was the...
Oh, that's a special edition. Remember the first one that was put out, the Pioneer DVD?
That looked like a meat in a pack?
No.
That was another one.
The first one, and then they released, I still think is the best set, they released like the Black Maria, I think Dark Sky Films did that one. Correct me if I'm wrong, I don't know. But it came in like the Black Maria, the truck at the end of the movie.
Oh yeah,
and it came
I saw
with like
that
a,
one.
A cooking apron.
Oh, that's cool. God.
But that transfer is amazing.
Did make one that looked like it was meat in packaging.
Yeah.
What does this one say? Sorry, I want to see if this describes the plot better.
Read it like Gunner.
Okay.
This is the
no. Now you sound like Haggerty. Dan Haggerty.
This is the bizarre. I can't do Gunner.
No, you're good. You're good.
This is the bizarre and tragically gruesome account of what happened to five young friends one summer afternoon in rural Texas. After hearing reports of a grave robbing, the group sets out to check on a family grave. Soon after, one by one, they wander into the murderous clutches of Leatherface. The Texas Chainsaw Massacre is a frightening classic that possesses an undying power to terrorize audiences again and again. Its ability to truly horrify is so strong that when the movie first opened, some people actually walked out in the state of shock. Real brave saying, hey, you might turn this movie off.
Making
me not want to buy it.
What is that? The third incarnation of the DVD? Like, I know we fucking quadruple dipped, but you should buy it again.
Yeah.
Oh man, this is a good.
You should have read it like John Larroquette.
Oh, that is John Larroquette in the original. A lot of people don't know that.
The Texas Chain Saw Massacre.
Whatever. What did they say? I think Joe Bob was talking about it. Like the mob was kind of involved with this film, and that's how people don't know how much money this made.
What were they really?
Something with the mob was involved with this film, and no one ever knows how much money this actually made because the mob kind of like pushed some stuff around.
That sounds familiar. I remember watching a documentary on one of the DVD releases that I feel like they talk about that.
Yeah, check out the Joe Bob episode he did on it. So anyway, Texas Chainsaw Massacre. What do you guys think of this movie? What are some of the pros?
It's a classic. It's still a 10 out of 10.
Yeah. You know, it's just... It does something that nothing was doing at the time, especially in 1974. And I think Black Christmas comes out the same year.
Yeah.
So you had, it was kind of still in the early stages of the genre, right?
Yes. The early slasher.
Or changing over, right? So like this was like huge. I mean, you still had Herschel Gordon Lewis stuff like from the late 60s and stuff like that. But like this film is just dirty.
Yeah.
And gritty, and it has that grindhouse kind of feel. And it's just, it makes you want to take a shower after you see this film.
It took me a while to like this movie when I was younger.
Really?
Yeah. I feel like late grade school, because again, we're the weirdos who watch this stuff way too young. Late grade school, I watch this, I'm like, what is this? Everyone's just yelling and shit. Like, Leatherface is kind of stupid. He's just lumbering around. And then when I got the DVD in high school, I watch it again. I'm just like, oh, you know what? This is actually really good. And then I kept watching. I'm like, I think I love this movie.
Oh yeah, dude. I was talking about, because we watched it the other night, and I was talking about the fact that like I didn't get really all the social commentary stuff until later.
Like, when they talk about older, how like small towns were dying.
The small towns were dying, and how
you
everything
can hide a lot of shady stuff because people moved out.
Everything's going out of business, and like the type of people out there kind of keep to themselves and turn the blind eye and all that kind of shit.
When did Deliverance come out?
1970. I don't know. It might even be late 60s. Is it late 60s or
Deliverance? I think would have not been
70.
But like Deliverance also kind of felt like this too.
Yeah, it's in the pocket.
Yeah,
for
yeah,
sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, there was like that time where they're like, what's going on in this little area of the country we don't really see?
Well, because it's isolated. And that was the thing. Like that's how, because there's nothing out there. There's no pay phones, there's no cell phones and shit like that. And that makes it pretty scary to me.
Yeah.
It's also playing up that whole idea, especially in that time period where people were just maybe a little too trusting of their fellow neighbor.
Yeah.
Because there's a lot in this, well, in the franchise overall, but especially in this first movie where it's like, random house in the middle of effing nowhere. Yeah. Sure.
Southern
let's
hospitality.
See if they give us directions.
Yeah.
Well, because they go there.
I know, but.
And then there's also like, I know this movie's not really like a satanic panic movie, but there's a lot of like stuff you could pull into like, because like they're desecrating a graveyard.
Yeah.
They're doing stuff you really shouldn't. Like again, you do like the like America. Everyone's always, every generation thinks America's losing its way and losing its soul. And this was probably a reference to that.
Again, it's heavily Ed Gein inspired. Like Ed Gein only killed a couple people, but he robbed like hundreds of graves.
Yes.
Maybe not hundreds, but a lot.
Yes.
So that was a big thing.
Yeah, and I guess people were getting more obsessed with like the whole like serial killer thing.
Yeah.
Because that's still relatively, like...
Well, we got Gacy and Bundy are already apprehended.
I guess, but this is like...
No, that was like 77?
I think that might be later. But, like, only in, like, the last, like, few decades has the whole, like, glamorizing a serial killer become, like, a thing.
I fucking hate it, dude.
Yeah, I don't know. I feel really weird about that. Like, the stories, they're interesting. They should be told what happened to these people. No. But I just... Let me get a coffee cup with Jeffrey Dahmer. Like, I don't get that.
That's a little like,
I have a coffee cup with Jeffrey Dahmer.
Wow. That's okay. Yeah. That's okay.
But what I mean is romanticizing it.
Yeah.
I.e., like, thinking that Ted Bundy's not such a bad guy.
Right.
And but he's so handsome and charming and that kind of shit. And it's like with that one with Zac Efron compared to like an actual documentary with like survivors of Ted Bundy.
Yeah.
That, go check that out. It's on Netflix. I don't remember what the name of it is. The Ted Bundy tapes, I think it is. That's the kind of content that should be coming out because we're telling the story. We're not glorifying his killings, you know what I mean?
Yeah. But yeah, definitely in the last few decades, people fell in love with like killers and stuff.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Sure. I mean,
and so this movie kind of represents that. And it's a horrifying film.
Yeah.
I could see people like me when I was a kid who grew up on later slashers looking at this like, this looks kind of cheap. And where's the music and whatnot?
It also has like this weird dark comedy in certain scenes that I think people just can't wrap their head around, especially like Franklin when he's like, he's pissed because he's in a wheelchair and he can't go upstairs and he's just like mocking them. There's stuff like that.
Yeah, when he's blowing the raspberries and shit. I love the Franklin character, by the way.
And obviously the dinner scene has a lot of dark comedy built into the insanity of that
scene. I don't
think
anyone expected Grandpa to actually be alive. That's a nice twist.
Yeah, that's a good one too.
And they allude to stuff in their like weird lore, like he killed so many people.
Yeah, Grandpa only did it in one hit.
Yeah.
You know?
That's like that scene. I mean, I don't know if you're about to get into how, I don't know how deep you want to get into the movie itself, because we got a lot to cover here. But
not
like,
too deep, but yeah, just
that's some of that dark comedy, I feel like. I mean, it's kind of like, I don't know if you would even call, maybe I'm just crazy, but
no,
it is kind of dark comedy.
No, it's
where
dark
Grandpa
comedy.
Is trying to hit her in the back of the head with a sledge, kind of mixed with tension, because you're like, this is kind of silly, but also like, holy shit, what's happening right now?
That actually, it's pitch perfect black comedy.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't
but
know.
You know
I
what
like
they
it.
Say, you know, families that have dinner together are usually stronger.
So. Yeah, it's about family. it's about family values.
Yeah.
Any cons for this film?
No, I was just gonna.
I guess if that mafia thing's true, you probably shouldn't fund the mafia. Well,
I wanted to just spotlight Ed Neal too as Nubbins or the Hitchhiker, because he's just fucking completely unhinged in this movie.
Yeah,
he's fantastic.
He's good.
And Jim Seidel is great too.
My con is don't like the title. They should have went with the original title.
Leatherface.
Head Cheese.
Oh, Head Cheese. Yeah.
We could be here. This episode could almost be called Worst Head Cheese Movie.
Wait, head Cheese, The Next Generation?
Yes! Head Cheese, Head Cheese 3D.
Oh, so what would Leatherface be called? Head?
No, I think he'd still be called Leatherface.
No, like the movie.
Oh, yeah, right.
Head.
Yeah.
Head Cheese 3.
The origin story of Head.
So, yes, that is the first Texas Chainsaw Massacre, I think. I don't think this is winning worst Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
No.
I mean, who knows? We'll wait till the end when we pick our one.
There's also one thing I just want to say, one more thing. For the first film, I think Leatherface, and as far as like icons of horror go, that first film holds up so well, and it holds up beyond like Jason or Freddy or Michael Myers.
Yeah. By the way, only kills one person with a chainsaw. He chops up another person with a chainsaw, but they're already dead.
Yeah.
More like Texas Chainsaw person.
The Texas Chainsaw Massacre, or the massacre in Texas that might have a chainsaw. Yeah.
And here's one thing about this movie, and before we move on, I think it's kind of important, because it kind of explains like why later sequels, when they try to be more like the other slashers, it doesn't work. Like, Leatherface isn't the guy. Like,
no.
It's all of them.
It's also
the family that is insane. He's like the scary looking one, but
yeah,
he's not even the first bad guy you're introduced to in this. He's the last one, really. Mm-hmm. Well, I guess Grandpa's the last one, but still.
It's also the idea of it all. You know, kind of really their culture is what's crazy.
Yeah. And then there's some movies later on that are like, it's the Leatherface.
Well, I got a lot of problems with the way they changed the Sawyer family after we get past the second one that we'll get into.
Yes.